My name is Łukasz Walikowski. I work here at Center for Open Science at Interdisciplinary Center for Mathematical and Computational Modeling at University of Warsaw. So what we do, I think the keyword for what we do would be interdisciplinarity. We have this, let's say, a comprehensive approach to open science with both computer scientists, sociologists, lawyers, working together and creating solutions for open science. And I would like to share with you very briefly one of such solutions. So part of our research at the center is focused on symptometrics. So on looking into looking into the ways that science progresses, that scientific community organizes itself, disseminates information, shares information, collaborates, etc. You can see a number of topics that fall into this this area. So we're interested in mobility of researchers, their career paths. You can be interested in the ways that countries collaborate. You can be interested in the way that funding is distributed, where it's going, how it differs between agencies, and so on. So the common denominator for all these activities is that they are data-based, data-driven, let's say, and that most of the information that we need is located either on the first or the last page of a paper. Right, so for instance, if you're interested in the priorities of funding agencies, you're looking at the acknowledgement sections, which is usually somewhere towards the end of a paper, and you are looking for keywords, which you can probably find on the first page. If not, then you can do run an algorithm for keyword extraction, which could be run only having abstract. If you have a full text, even better. But abstract, which is usually on the first page, would be enough. In general, the workflow is as follows. We start with documents, either PDFs or metadata, if we have it, if we have a good quality metadata. Then we extract information from that and infer relations between different entities such as people, institutions, funding agencies, documents, topics, etc. Then we do the kind of analysis that is the topic of our symptomatic pursuit at the moment, and the results are either some reports that could be publications, or could be somehow used in some software that is created. So this is I would say a rather typical workflow for data-driven symptometrics. What is important to realize here is that the first let's say arrow, so the one where we create this network, is rather complex. I mean, it can depending on the project that you are working on, could be very time-consuming, very difficult to do. So what we wanted to do is to do it once and do it right. I have this analogy with Common Crawl. Maybe some of you are aware of this excellent resource. It's what they did was they basically crawled a couple of billion of pages on the internet, and which is a difficult task. It's expensive task. It's a task which can fail in many different ways. So technically, it's not a it's difficult in a technical way, right? So they did this. Well, they are doing this periodically, and the results are stored on Amazon Web Services. They are publicly available to anyone who's interested. They are licensed using CC BY-SA, so Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike license, and anyone who has a desire to do anything creative with them can do so, right? So one of the things one could try to do is to build their own Google search, so to speak. So what we are trying to achieve with Common Map of Academia is is allow people to build their own Google Scholars, so to speak. Or perform some research based on the information that is usually difficult to come up with. I mean, if you have a big project, that usually you have resources to create such such resources. But when you have a rather, let's say, a smaller research question that you would like to address, then you might be discouraged to prepare all the data that's necessary for that. And what we are trying to do is to lower this entry barrier for such stoichiometric research. So where are we right now? At this moment, we have after the duplication, we've gathered around 20 million open, 20 million documents or metadata about 20 million documents. And we are only here interested in openly, publicly available information. So there is no. I mean, as the University of Warsaw, we have access to much more publications from STM publishers. But what we are talking about here is information that is publicly available on the internet. From that, we inferred 220 million relations and counting. And some of the results are already used in services that we build, because I didn't mention that, but Center for Open Science is also very much an important aspect of it is building software for the scientific community for open science. So we are in some of the services that we are building, we are already using this data set to enrich the information that we have. Well, we are just about to I was hoping that we that by the time that today I would be able to announce this data set, but we do have to check the legal status of some of the material that we have. But the first public version should be available later this month. It will be definitely on an open license, either CC BY or CC BY SA. As I said, we have to be very careful with the licensing here. I would encourage you to visit comac.cion.pl for any updates on this project. And we are very excited to be at this stage in which we have this resource that took, well, it was mostly the time the one of the biggest challenges was the inference part, right? So all the algorithms for deduplication, for author name disambiguation, and all of that. So it's a fruit of tour. More than 2 years of work of several people with background in machine learning and text mining, and we are very excited to be able to present it. As I said, later this month you will be able to download this resource. It will be available in the RDF format, so it's pretty convenient for any semantic analysis. So that is it from my side. I tried to be brief. I hope I didn't exceed time. And yes, thank you.